Jerome Tilak Singh. I'm a resident of Chaguanas. I'm a university student at UV St. Augustine, and I have a few criticisms and suggestions for the budget. First of all, I believe it's a utopian budget, and that there are certain shortcomings that we must take into consideration. First of all, Mr. Quayton cannot believe that increasing infrastructure and increasing human resources will solve these problems. For instance, domestic violence. We cannot believe that establishing centers next to the police stations will help this problem. What about the personnel who will run these centers? Who will train them? Where will they be trained? What about if policemen commit acts of domestic violence and these centers are next to the police station? Also, on the topic of crime, I noticed that there will be the establishment of divisional headquarters. There will be 70 police stations throughout the country will be computerized. Computers are fine, but some policemen don't have cars. They don't have guns. Why are we giving them computers for? We should equip them better. And I believe we should also have a program, a better selection process to deal with corrupted police officers. This has been a recent plague in Trinidad, and I think we really need to see about this. Society is afraid of their policemen, and we need to tackle this problem. And I hope that there will be infrastructure to deal with this. Secondly, on the topic of health system. $1 billion has been spent on the health system. Sure, hospitals has been established in the rural areas. Mention has been made of at least 60 beds in San Fernando Hospital. But what about the problems of shortages of medicine? What about no generators at the Port Spain Hospital? What about the attitude of nurses and doctors to the patients? We need to take this into consideration. Solving the problem is not by creating more hospitals, establishing more police stations. We need to understand the attitude of society, the attitude of people manning these buildings. And as a university student, I am concerned about the high cost of university education. It is beyond the reach of the working class people. This is not a people's budget. This is not a working class budget. This is a budget for the upper class and the middle class, upper middle class. But it's not a working class budget. Nothing about university education here. A-level graduates, they cannot go to university directly. Many of them take years off working, saving up their money. They can't afford to take loans to repay these loans. University education must be accessible to the working class people. Or else, you know what will happen? Every month we will continue having road protests. We will continue having protests in this country. The last 2 years we have witnessed that. It has increased. And I think that education at the tertiary level needs to be accessible. Our former Prime Minister, Dr. Eric Williams, great historian, he must be rolling in his grave now to realize that a lot of students are denied a university education because of the high price. And I wish that this budget would have dealt with it on a better scale. And my final point is that Mr. Quayton has mentioned there's no new taxes, no increased taxes. This is a smoke screen, and I want the public to brace themselves. If this year is a good budget, next year we're in trouble. Okay? And also, I think the public needs to understand and to look closer at this budget. If there's no taxes, and there is no increase in taxes, and we are looking at around with a figure of $13 billion, we need to examine more closely public sector investment programs, long-term framework, medium policy frameworks. What will be the impact? What will be the repercussions on society? So we cannot just believe and go away smiling, thinking this is a nice budget, this is a people's budget, no taxes, no new taxes. We get in hospitals, we get in football stadiums, and we get in more police stations. We need to understand it's the people running these institutions and what will be the impact on this generation and the future generation. Thank you.
Thank you.